Hi, welcome to KDB5 video tutorial. Today I want to do a very simple mechanism with a very simple assembly. So let's take a look. If I move that slider, you will see that part here, the tilting part, moves along that slot here and along that slot, and it makes that part tilt. Okay, let's take a look from the other side. Same. In order to do that mechanism in KDB5, you have to do some preparation, because it might be simpler in other programs, but in KDB5 you have to use certain joints, and for those joints you need some helpers. Anyway, let's have fun with KDB5. Okay, I've already created a new and empty assembly. Let's bring into that product one those two parts. And that's guide plate C and tilting plate, tilting part C. Go for open, it should bring in those two parts. Confirm. And I want to color this one in a different color. Let's go for, yeah, cyan. And I don't need this one visible and that one visible. Great. In order to position those parts correctly, I will need helper elements. First, I want to fix that guide plate. So go for fix, okay, and hide it for the moment. So let's zoom in. I will need a line from that arc center to that arc center. Therefore, I will go into the part and I will use a 3D line. So lock it up. Point is okay. Go for create a point, lock it, and that would be circle, sphere, ellipse, center. That's okay. And for the second one as well. And that would be this arc. Okay. In order to make it better visible, let's give it a different width. Okay, great. Now I will need another line, and that would be sort of an axis of this bolt here. Yes. So let's see if we can do it the same way. Point to point would be okay. And again, I want to create it with a center of a circle, sphere, or ellipse. Let's see if we can use this one here, or maybe that edge here, this edge. Okay. And maybe that edge here, this one. Okay, this looks good. Confirm, and again make it in a different width. Okay, great. So let's go back to our product. Oh, sorry, I forgot. I want to publish those two lines. So that would be the slot line. So go for tools, publication, and that line would be the slot center line, sort of. So let's call this one slot line, and that would be the tilting part, so I call this TP. Okay. And should be here, yes. And that would be the axis of that bolt. So I want to publish this one here, and this would be the axis bolt TP, and confirm. Okay, now let's collapse this, go back to our product, hide the tilting part, and show the guide plate. Now I will need an axis here and a sort of center line here. Let's go into that part, the guide plate, and I want to go for a 3D line. Again, point, again, grid point, again, it's circle, sphere, ellipse, center, lock it, and that would be from this arc center to that arc center. Okay. Confirm, make it like that, and I could already publish it. So go for publication. Yes, the selected element, and that would be the axis, and let's call it bolt, and that would be the guide plate, should call it GP. Confirm. And for that center line, let's bring in that one just in order to take a look where I want to go. Yeah. I will do a sketch on this surface here. So let's go for a sketch on that surface. Let's hide those yellow projected elements. And now I need to bring in those edges. Now, in order to create that center line, I need to bring in those edges, at least as construction elements. So, let's see how we can do this. Now, if I dimension those elements, that's obviously a radius. That's a radius. And this one as well. And the radius is 7.6. All those edges are arcs. And of course, I've checked before with an extract if those edges are tangent continuous, and there are. And they are. So I need arcs. I need an arc which starts here at the center. And then let's zoom in. Now try to avoid snapping. Maybe like that. Okay. And this should be not for construction. And that arc should be somehow centered to this one. So let's see if we can center it. Concentricity. Goes to the other side, that's interesting, but doesn't matter, I can move it around in that direction. Really? That's crazy. Okay, so I want to go for that complementary arc, which is possible here. That's not the one. Where is it? That's an option here. No. No. I think it's in the trim command. Yeah. There you go. I need the complement. Like that. Nice. Now we need another arc which goes in that direction. So go for a 3-point arc. Start here at that point and then don't snap like that. And there should be a tangency between those two elements. Tangency. Great. And this one should be concentric to that arc. Looks good. Now let's move this point, if possible. Yeah, slightly over here. And I need another arc, which starts at this point, goes in that direction, and then ends here at the center of that arc. Okay. Now let's try to make a tangent here. Yes. And of course it should be concentric to this one here. Let's see if that works. Great. Now I've got my center line. If you wonder why I did it like this, because I ran into some sort of problems if I tried to do it in one move. Okay, and I will put this curve out like that. Leave that sketch, and I want to publish that element as well. And it should be here, that output feature, like that, that profile, and I want to publish it. Tools, publication, yes, and let's call this one the guide slot curve. Guide slot curve, and it's in the guide part. A guide plate and confirm. And now go back to our product and bring in that part. No, I'm not finished yet because I need points. I need a point on that axis and a point on this axis. Okay, so I want to go back in my tilting part, and in that tilting part I need a point, and that point would be the intersection point between this axis and that surface, or I could go for a plane. So let's create a plane. That plane should be positioned right there, and it should have no offset, so that offset should be zero. And now I want to create a point, and that would be an intersection point, which is not possible here. So I can go for on curve or on planar. So I go for on curve, and that would be on this curve. And the reference point would be an intersection between this plane and that line. And the distance from this point should be, of course, zero, which gives me that point here, and I might also publish that point. Publication, yes, and that would be the point in the tilting part, and confirm. So I can collapse this, and I've got those three elements here. Now go into the guide plate, and I need another point here. Same procedure. I will go for a plane, which is located on this surface here, distance 0, and I need a point. That would be a point on a curve. This would be the curve, and the reference would be an intersection between this plane here and that curve. And the distance should be, of course, 0. And that point should be published as well. Tools, publication, yes. And that would be point in the tilt. No, it's not in the tilting part, that's in the sliding part. The sliding part. No, in the guide part, sorry. Okay, go back to our product, collapse this, and we've got those publications. And now I can position my parts correctly by using a coincidence. Or let's go first for that contact, and this should be, of course, between, where can I grab that surface? Yeah, okay. So between this surface and, let's hide that part for the moment, and come on. This surface here. Okay, bring it back. And now go for the coincidence between that point, and that would be the point of the guide part and the slot line in the tilting part. That's an update or refresh, and again the point in the tilting part should be aligned with that curve. That's not possible, but I can go for the end point of that curve. So maybe hide the tilting part and go for that point here and bring it back. Now let's test if this works. We can explode it and then make an update. So if I go for explosion, product, yes, no fixed product, yes, all levels, yes, apply, okay, okay, yes, and if we refresh it, it should jump back into position. And it's necessary to position those points with the coincident on those curves. Otherwise, we cannot make the simulation. Now, I almost forgot something. This curve, in order to use it, it has to be a joint federation, a joint curve. So let's go back to the guide plate. And I want to join those three arcs, because maybe we cannot select it. So just make it a join, and then we should be able to select it. That join could be, of course, also published, and let's call this just join. That should do, and now we can switch back to the product, collapse this, and switch to the DMU kinematics workbench. Now, in order to make a mechanism, we have first to fix one part, and that would be this one. Let's make it a new mechanism. Name doesn't matter. OK, Okay, and I want to fix this part. Now I need a sliding joint between those two parts. So maybe just maybe put it over there. And the slider should be this one. Planar joint, yes. Between this surface and, of course, let's hide the guide plate for a moment. This surface here. Okay. Bring it back. And now I need two point on curve joints. So, where is it? That's the one point curve joint. So this point here, that would be the point in the tilting part. But first I need to select the curve. The curve would be this curve, and that would be the join. And the point would be the point in the tilting part. And this should be length driven. Okay. And I need another point curve joint between the point in the, now it's in the guide plate and the slot line. So first select the slot line and then the point. And now this should be able to be simulated, yes. Maybe hide those, hide these, hide the plane and this plane, hide the constraints, and now I could simulate this. So go here, go for immediate, and then if you move that slider, the tilting part moves and tilts. So quite a lot of preparation to make it work. In other programs that might be easier to do. So hope it was helpful. Hope you liked it. If you did like it, please give it a like or leave a comment. If you want to see more, please give it a like or leave a comment. Please subscribe to my YouTube channel. Please subscribe to my Facebook cat fan page. Would be very nice of you. I want to get more likes and subscriptions over there as well. Thanks for watching. See you to the next one. Bye bye.